Hello folks, it's me, RH131, and we're back again with some more World of Tanks Blitz. Today we will be playing the Tier 6 Soviet Heavy Tank, the KV-2. KV-2 is a Tier 6 Soviet Heavy Tank, the others being the T-150 and the KV-1S. And it's, KV-2 really does a good job of combining the better aspects of those two tanks. It's probably more so related to the KV-1S, and I'll explain why throughout the course of this video, than the T-150, but it overall combines the two to a degree. It has slightly better hull armor than the KV-1S at a cost to which the reload time on this gun, not the best. The gun, on the other hand, to explain the gun to you, I'll just wait until I, there we go. That's all you need to know about the gun right there. Unfortunately, one of the sacrifices, it does get slightly better than the KV-1S, but does not get a lot of armor. So, 53 hit points. Well, it's a Soviet tank, and that means communism, and communists do not need hit points. The KV-2 only needs one hit point to stay in the match and continue to deliver 152mm bombshells of communism to the enemy. As that KV-2 found out, this gun is able to hit a target at any range, despite any obstacles whatsoever. Thanks to the glorious guidance systems of Stalin's hand himself, this gun will 100% hit the target as long as you are in good graces with Stalin himself. Now, this Churchill 3, not able to penetrate him frontally with the high explosive, neither is he able to penetrate us with his high explosive, but as you can see, there's still at around 300 damage to the front of his tank, just with high explosive not penetrating. And that's really the thing about the KV-2. It's got the gun for it, but it just doesn't have the armor. So you're gonna want to play this more. Not so much entirely second-line support tank, but you're going to want to play it back further than you would, say, a T-150 at the same thing. It's decent side-scraping tank, but you really don't want to be side-scraping with the DPM that you have, which the ability to one-shot tanks is very good, but, if you get caught alone and outnumbered, then you're most likely going to die just because of the fact that your gun takes pretty much a third of a minute to reload. Now, this, how do you pronounce, you know what, we're just gonna call that a toaster, because thanks to the penetration abilities of my explosive shell, the German crew inside is now a toasty, toasty, burning mess. Now I stop here for a minute to, express my opinions of Retard, Captain Retard in his Kuro, who decided that the best course of option when faced with two hidden tank destroyers that had really good rates of fire, he decided that the best course of option was to tank his tank that has really not a lot of armor and rush them blindly without any idea knowing where they were. And surprisingly, that ended with his death. I know, shocker. So he's gonna be a really good entertainment value for the rest of the match. Let me tell you, in-game chat feature, best entertainment ever. 100%. I wish they would have kept global chat, because that was a good entertainment section as well. Now, the only tank left on the enemy team is another toaster. I'm 90% sure he's in their spawn, or at least he was in their spawn whenever he was shooting that Kuro. So we're just gonna have to wait for somebody else to go spot him, because I've got 53 hit points in Russian V-range, and no amount of Stalin's grace can help fix your V-range in this tank. Now that that toaster tank certifies he's not there, we're going to skip a little bit ahead to the point where we do actually spot him, because that was probably better than just watching 40 seconds of me drive backwards and forwards in this 40-meter circle. Now, we don't kill him there, but on the right side, knocks out his gun, so he's unable to return fire. I pulled the trigger a little bit earlier than I would have liked to, but if I would have waited, you most likely would have been able to kill me. So I had to snap that shot off, and good result, good result. 5 rounds fired, 5 hits, and 5 penetrating, damaging shots. I'm going to use penetrating and damaging interchangeably in this video, just because with high explosive, if you hit a target, you're going to do damage with it, especially with this gun. So as you can see there, 2,250 damage, good result. Moving on, next match is on Black Goldville. Again, top tier. When you're not top tier in this tank, then you're going to want to play it as a second line support tank, because you're no longer going to have the ability to completely one-shot tanks. Even if you've got tanks like lightly armored tanks like the Chiri, you're still not going to be able to really one-shot them because the high explosive just doesn't have enough damage. So if you're not top tier, definitely second line support tank. Now, the importance of firing high explosive cannot be stressed enough, because the penetration on this gun, it is a, for lack of a better word, it's a howitzer, it's a derp gun. It's not going to have the penetration with armor piercing, even with the premium armor piercing rounds, it's not going to have the penetration really to get through tanks 100% of the time. You're going to want to use high explosive pretty much on any tank you're fighting. The only reason I carry 6 armor piercing rounds in this, and there's a special armor piercing, the premium rounds, is because tanks like the Panzer IV Enko and the Panzer IVS with the side skirts, that's what you're going to want to use those armor piercing rounds for, because the side skirts will eat up the high explosive. Now, so far we have not spotted anything, so that tells me they're either camping spawn or they're in the town. So we're just going to slowly trundle along here. Mobility on this tank, not the best, not the worst, falls somewhere in the middle. Turret traverse, definitely bad. Very bad. Takes a very long time for this turret to traverse around. Now they're able to finish off that toaster down there, but the leopard gets knocked out by a storm of fire. And I believe we lost another tank. I can't exactly tell where he died at, but I know he was taken out around the same time as the leopard. So that tells me that most of the enemy teams clustered around the bottom left corner of the map here. See an SU-85I down there. Premium tier 5 Russian tank destroyer. He's getting annihilated by all sides. I'm 90% sure. I think he's AFK. Might have been AFK. It's in the spawn area. It didn't do anything if he wasn't AFK. So he might as well have been. We bounced something down there from the town. Not exactly sure what that was. Wasn't this KV-2, however, because his turret isn't even in the right direction at all. Now that should have one-shot him there, but the round went a little bit higher and hit the top of his turret, so it wasn't able to penetrate, do full damage. So he's going to get away on about 400-ish health, half health for him. We're going to sit back here and wait for our gun to reload. And that's really how you want to play while you're reloading. Don't risk taking a hit in this tank. That's also true for any other tank. Do not risk taking a hit if you don't have to. If there's an area where you can pull back and not risk taking a hit, do it, because never, ever put the game into the random number generator's hands. RNG will screw you over 99% of the time. As you can see there, I aimed on the gray portion of his tank, still round went low into his tracks and dissipated the explosive damage. I do believe that's the side of a KV-1S. That doesn't have a lot of armor, I don't think. Let's see what Stalin thinks. Yep, Stalin agrees. Does not have a lot of armor at all. So that's pretty much a one-shot. Might as well have been a one-shot. Thinking about going for that SU-85 down there. Oh, hello! That's a nice 122mm gun you have. I don't have one of those. I have a 152mm gun. It kind of one-shots things like that. Yeah. Enjoy your battle. Hope you had a good time. Believe this SU-85. Don't think he has any idea what's going on around him. Looks like he's crying to his mother at this point. He was not informed that he was going to be shot at during this match. We're just going to dive off this cliff here. And thanks to the fact that friendly fire is disabled, you can fire point blank by your pack and not kill yourself. It's great. Is this M6? Yep, he's going to bounce off my ass because Stalin. And he's hit. So that's basically all you need to know about the KV-2. Just play it like you would a long reload tank destroyer. Don't play it like it has a lot of armor. But you have the maneuverability to outflank certain areas, keep up a little bit. It's not exactly an E-100 in speed. So, just another regular balanced Russian tank. There's so many in this game, I highly recommend you try them. That's all for today, folks, and I'll catch you next time.